What's up guys, it's Ryan here with another video, and today we're gonna be unboxing and checking out the 15.6 inch monitor from a company called Intel. Quick disclaimer, Intel did send this monitor out to me for free, but as always, I'll be giving my honest opinion on this monitor. Also, I will be linking this monitor in the description below along with the company website for those who want to check out their products. So the monitor was packaged pretty nicely in a white box. There was no logo on the box, but I don't think it would have made the unboxing experience any better. When I opened the box, it became clear that Intel did take the time to package the monitor as best as possible. As you can see here, the monitor is on top when you open the box. However, the lid of the box had this spongy padding to help protect the monitor during transport. In the box, there was also a USB-C to USB-C cable, a USB-A to USB-C cable, a HDMI to mini HDMI cable, and a 5-volt adapter that I don't think was wise, but that's something that we'll talk about later in the video. So the monitor has a 15.6 IPS display with a 1080p resolution. It has a refresh rate of 60Hz and a response time of 2 milliseconds. The viewing angles was pretty good. It had a 178 degrees all-rounded viewing angle, but what surprised me was how bright the 300 nits look while gaming or viewing content. The monitor does pack a pair of 2-watt speakers that are not spectacular, but they get the job done. I mean, it's a portable monitor, what do you expect? If you're planning to keep this stationary, I would recommend picking up a pair of speakers or use some headphones. The design of the monitor is okay. The bezels on the top and side are small, but the chin takes up more space to accommodate for the pair of speakers that I mentioned earlier. On the left side of the monitor, there's a power button, a power indicator, a dial button to adjust the settings, and a headphone jack. On the right side, there's two USB-C ports, one to supply power if you're using an iPad, iPhone, or any device that doesn't supply power via Thunderbolt 3. So in the case of the Mac Mini, you can only use the Type-C port at the bottom, and it will supply power and transmit audio and video at the same time. There's also a mini HDMI port on the right side, in case you need to use it. The weight of the monitor is okay, because it's made of plastic and aluminum alloy. The monitor can be connected to your console, laptop, smartphone, or desktop. But enough of the specs, let's see how it actually performs. So the first thing I did was to hook the monitor up with my iPad Pro for some Call of Duty gaming, and it worked really well. I tried to connect it to my iPhone, but it didn't work. Maybe because it wasn't a true Type-C to Type-C connection. But if someone knows how to get this working properly with an iPhone, comment below and let me know. I would really appreciate it. Next thing I did was connect it to my PS4, and again, the performance was great. I even use it as an extra monitor on my cousin's laptop running Windows 10. But what surprised me the most was how sharp and bright the display looked when I connected it to my 2018 Mac Mini as an additional display. But you guys might be wondering how I didn't mention anything bad about the monitor. Well, that's because there's just a few, and I left them for last. And the first one is the 5-volt adapter that came with the monitor. Personally, I don't think it is ideal for the monitor, because when I was using it to provide power for the monitor, it got really warm after like 45 minutes. The second thing is that I wish it could have been VESA mounted. Despite the fact that it came with a magnetic stand, I still would rather have something more sturdy holding the monitor. But again, it was meant to be a portable monitor, so I'm just nitpicking here. The third thing is that it's not a touch-enabled display. But other than that, I think it's a solid monitor with great performance for the price of $149. The size makes it really portable, and you can take it with you wherever, whenever, with no issue. I would definitely recommend this monitor, especially if you want to do some gaming on the go, or if you want an extra screen for your laptop. So guys, that's it for this video. Remember to subscribe and turn on notifications so you won't miss any video. Until next time, it's your boy Ryan here with Home of Tech. Peace.